Today, we're here at our place, LA Percussion Rentals Warehouse 1. And what we're gonna be doing is recording a whole bunch of pretty eclectic instruments from a number of iconic movie scores. This project came about because I was actually contacted by Tim Rodier of Omni Music Publishing. Omni Music Publishing is a company that essentially goes and takes the manuscripts from many iconic films and publishes them for composers and music enthusiasts alike to basically be able to check out whether they want to study it or they just want to follow along. He said to me, hey, do you want to record all of these eclectic instruments that you have to some of these scores that I publish? I was like, absolutely, sounds great. So here we are today.
Back to the Future's iconic reveal of the DeLorean is achieved with a bowed cymbal. A Super Bowl rubbed on gong. Yes, the same Super Bowl you played with as a child. And Glockenspiel. Abby explains why this particular Glockenspiel is so sought after.
I don't know exactly what it's been used on, but this is an antique Glockenspiel, Deegan round tops. And on here, I think it's stamped 1908. These are pretty sought after, especially in the orchestral scene, for their timbre. They're really sparkly and bright, and they're just, the bars are really thick, so it just has like a really special quality to it that really cuts, but brings a beautiful timbre.
Here is what it all sounds like together. Don Davis uses a lot of percussion in The Matrix, but two of the most unusual instruments are the bowed styrofoam cup and the trans-celeste. The trans-celeste, named for Emil Richards' wife, is the only one in existence. It is mounted metal bars tuned to the Indian Shruti scale of 22 tones per octave. Now let's turn our attention to Bruce Broughton's classic score for the 1985 Western, Silverado. This is largely a traditional sounding Western, but because it's Broughton, it's very sophisticated with sometimes subtle musical effects. It is orchestration mastery. Part of the mastery comes not only from some of the off-the-beaten-path percussion choices, but using them in some unusual ways. Take the maracas, for example. Usually these Latin instruments are shaken rhythmically, but Broughton instructs the player to turn them slowly for an eerie effect. The güiro, a Brazilian instrument, is usually scraped rhythmically like this. But for the cue, "You're empty, mister," the composer uses a sort of jeté back and forth rhythm. Simultaneously sounding are the Hawaiian puili sticks, a bundle of bamboo struck together, the jawbone is literally from the jaw of a donkey or mule. When struck, the loose teeth make a bone-chilling rattling noise. Another rattling instrument, this time with stacked discs, is the Egyptian sistrum. A quick flick of the wrist produces a unique effect. The ratchet produces a grinding sound by swinging a handle attached to gears whose teeth scrape across a wooden board. What you're hearing is the tune "Lujan" by Henry Mancini. Its melody is based around the pitches the Lujan percussion instruments can produce. The one Abby is playing was made in the mid-1950s. What you're looking at is one of about only three in the world. There are so many wonderful percussion instruments utilized in Danny Elfman's Batman score, but the most ubiquitous instrument is the waterphone. When a bow is scraped across its spokes, an eerie screeching effect is achieved, perfect for the roasted dude cue. Agogo bells are usually reserved for pop music, but Elfman employs them during the Batmobile chase. Similar to a cowbell, but higher pitched, notice how Abby has them mounted and is playing them with sticks. It's a tricky instrument to play, but the chromatic boobams can add a wonderfully deep, tubular, and almost tropical sound to a melody. Another of Elfman's classic scores is Edward Scissorhands, which is sadly no longer available from Omni Music Publishing. It's too bad because it contains so much original and melodic music made all the more magical, like in this cue with the use of song bells. The song bells is pitched an octave lower than the Glockenspiel and more mellow. Notice how the twinkling of this instrument perfectly captures the visuals of gently falling snow. James Horner created a most unusual palette for the 1992 film Sneakers. For a heist movie, soprano saxophone, three pianos, and crotales might seem an unlikely choice, but listen to the effect those and others have on the opening of the film. The African talking drum produces different pitches by squeezing the strings under the arm. Claves are a well-known percussion instrument, but consider which pitch you want because each one can have a different subtle effect. In addition to this dreamlike music, Horner uses a groove of sandpaper blocks and hi-hat opening and closing to represent the ragtag group of hackers. At the end of Spock Walk from Star Trek, the motion picture, xylophone hammers out alternating E-flat major 7 and B minor chords, accompanied by the bamboo Devil Chasers. Elsewhere in the cue, as piano performs a dizzying rising figure, a wind machine aids in the crescendo. The sound is produced by cranking a barrel with a canvas around it. The Indonesian angklungs are featured throughout the score, but especially in the Klingons. The instruments are carved from bamboo to have resonant pitches. The slit drum is an African instrument carved from wood. In Star Trek, Goldsmith instructs the players to use Super Bowl mallets.
So this is like the rub rods that are a hollow tube. So the other ones that we were using are round rods that are not hollow. And these just have a little bit of a different kind of vibe to them. They're a little more pure. In reality, what Emil told me is he didn't use these as much because a lot of the composers wanted to use the ones that had a little bit more of a complex timbre. One of the reasons I knew it was this set that was used more rarely is because this set goes G to G, while the other set goes F to F. And Star Trek calls for a high F sharp, which does not exist on that instrument. So it was kind of cool to know pretty much for sure that it was this actual instrument that was used in Star Trek, the film.
John Powell greatly enhanced the sonic landscape for How to Train Your Dragon with many non-traditional percussion instruments. Take the opening cue, this is Burke. When the tone turns gruff and barbaric, Powell uses the Indian dhal rhythmically to match the warring Vikings. Notice how the score calls for a high and low pitch. The tassels along the drum can be tightened to raise the pitch and loosened to lower it. The cue Forbidden Friendship is one of the most beloved cues from the film. It is a complete 180-degree turn from the previous cue and features the slate or stone marimba, glass marimba, a shaker, and, later on in the cue, the Egyptian goblet drum, also known as the dumbek or darbuka. This video only scratches the surface. There are many percussion instruments that appear in the Omni Music Publishing books, and these are just some of them. This video is merely to shed light on instruments that aren't normally featured, how they sound individually and within the context of a cue. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.
If you like what you see here, push subscribe and hit that bell. Because that action helps me be able to create more content.